and sisters, in Christ we were also chosen, destined and acquired for the purpose of the one who accomplishes all things according to the intention of his will, so that we might exist for the praise of his glory, we who first hoped in Christ. In him you also, who have heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and have believed in him, were sealed with the promised Holy Spirit, which is the first installment of our inheritance toward redemption as God's possession, to the praise of his glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Bless the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Bless the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Exalt you just in the Lord. Praise from the upright is fitting. Give thanks to the Lord on the harp with the 10-string lyre. Chant his praise.
Bless the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
For upright is the word of the Lord, and all his works are trustworthy. The Lord loves justice and right. Of his kindness, of the kindness of the Lord, the earth is full.
Bless
the nation whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen for his own inheritance. From heaven the Lord looks down. God sees all mankind.
Bless the people the Lord has chosen.
Our prayer life, cheating or skill in any little sense, that's taking us away from the purpose of our existence, the purpose of our destiny. And Jesus says in today's gospel, you better not do that, because there is nothing concealed that will not be revealed, nor secret that will not be known. Therefore, whatever you have said in the darkness will be heard in the light. When you stand in judgment next to Jesus, he's going to ask me, he's going to ask you, did you fulfill your destiny? As my adopted child, to my father, by the blood of my cross that I gave to you? Or did you waste your time doing stupid things that have nothing to do with who you've been called to be? This glorified creature in heaven with me forever. I've laid this out for you. I've given you this path. Are you following? Did you follow it? Or were you in darkness doing horrible sins? I tell you, my friends, he says, don't be afraid of those who kill the body. In other words, don't follow what society is saying that it's wrong. Even if you may be ridiculed, even if they may kill you. But he says, be afraid of more of the one who, after you have died, can put your butt in hell. That's Jesus. He can do that to us. And he says, be afraid of me. Don't be afraid of them, because I'm the one, and I'm the only one who's going to judge you. And therefore, if you have lived and struggled to be a person in the destiny that I set out to you by giving God praise in everything you do, when you come to me in judgment, for the wages of sin is death, so Paul tells us very clearly we are going to die, and Jesus tells us in Romans, it's appointed for man to be born once and upon death to be judged immediately. That's right out of Scripture. So the minute we die, we're with Jesus, and he sets out our judgment. And he reviews our life. And he's going to ask, did you fulfill your destiny? Did you do what you were supposed to do? Or did you waste your time on things that had nothing to do with the goal that I put forth for you to fulfill? Something I need to think about, something we all need to think about, because it's serious stuff. Take your faith and your relationship with Jesus. It is the only thing that matters in the end. Amen. Amen. Let's now bring our Father in heaven to you with our prayers and petitions. We pray to have more fervor in our commitment to serve Jesus and to give our Father in heaven the praise and the glory that he is due in all our actions and in all our thoughts every day. And for this we pray to the Lord.
Amen.
Pray for all the members of our family that none will be lost but all come to salvation in Christ. And for this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And we pray for the end of the coronavirus, the end to racism, abortion, and all other evils that plague our society today. And for this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And in common we pray for the souls in purgatory, especially those that are most afflicted. And for this we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
give them to you for the love of our Holy Mother Mary as we pray.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Be seated. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread and offered you through the earth and work of human hands, and to become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you through the vine and work of human hands, and to become our spiritual drink.
Thank you.
preach us how beauty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being, and while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit from whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting sharing of the paschal mystery. And so with all the angels we praise you in joyful celebration, we acclaim.
Holy, Lord, Lord God, of heaven and earth.
The mystery of faith. We proclaim the death of the Lord and the confession of resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to. Humbly, we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, the church spread throughout the world and bring her into the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Douglas, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostle St. Michael, St. Jules, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the same time, we may be always free from sin and safe from all.